Okay. Welcome back once again, if you are back. So, we just got done with the off season, and if you didn't see, I highly recommend you at least watch some of it. I'll post it up on YouTube soon. But yeah, we got a lot of pieces that we needed. You know, we picked up a lot. And it was evident, too, when I did the game prep. I did two of the running backs. Tevin Coleman and the new running back that we have, Martin. And let me tell you something. That offensive line is definitely there and is definitely doing its thing. So we have week one here of the season against the Broncos, who now have Sam Bradford at quarterback. Only Bradford is hurt. So they have Matt Moore now playing. So we're going to go ahead and get this game underway. I don't want to waste too much time doing this. But, here's a quick overview, I guess, of the team that you can see real quick. And again, I'll post all of this on YouTube, Shakira725. And if you aren't already, make sure you follow me on Twitter as well, so that way you get all my updates for when I'm about to play and whatnot, and post up videos and everything on YouTube as well. Our offensive line now includes Nick Fairley and Brandon Mabane, which are both very good players. So, welcome back again, Rawlington. Yeah, I do. I actually, wait a little bit even before I start talking. So right now I'm actually just, going through a little bit of what we picked up. But, and then also a new wide receiver in Nelson, who I don't actually remember his first name. Reggie Nelson, there we go. And new safety, rather. And you can see that he is pretty darn good so far. He's going to have big things happen for us. And then we also have this dude, Ward, who is a rookie, who should be good for us. But yeah. Hardy is the slot. Yes, I did move him up. we have this new receiver here, though. This is who I meant to say. Brandon. Dellens Brandon. 6'4 rookie. From Bama, by the way, which means him and Julio were at the same school. Just saying. They're producing some good wide receivers over there. He was our first pick at a draft, I think. And he should be good. So, some players like Hardy will get a chance. We picked up Chris Ivory. He'll get in there too in this game, be our number one running back. Oh, before I forget, actually, let me go over here to coach. Is there a way to change? I doubt it. Nah, that's not what I wanted. Oh, well. I wanted to see if there was a formation sub thing, but I don't see it over there. So we'll just roll with what we got. Here we go. Week one. Well, he better be a good cover safe. 83! Man, they're still cheating us on this overall rating. That's some bull. But you know what? We don't care about that. We're going to come out at home week one. We should get Trent Richardson. Here we go. I'm excited about this. But yeah, Rawlington, man. I did the little running back practice. And let me tell you, that blocking was evident. You could really see that the blockers had changed, because it was almost too easy of a drill. Especially when Coleman was in there. He was running left and right over people. Now that other running back, the 62 rookie that we got, he actually has a little pop to him, surprisingly. I don't know if it's in his ratings or not, but he ran over Ishmael like it was nothing in that drill. So, we'll see what happens. That's just the first goal. They got like four tiers of goals. So, it's tier one goal is 3 wins. Probably tier four is all the way up at 12 wins, is my guess. It's the Falcons going up against the Broncos. I do worry about Matt Ryan aging on here. Matt Moore. Are you kidding me? We ought to kill him. Whoa, what the heck? Oh, don't tell me they changed. Okay. You know what? I wasn't paying attention. When I made this league, I didn't think about taking off the whole changing stadiums and all of that mess. So the owner actually built the stadium on here. And apparently we have a new stadium now, which is fine because we're going to have a new one in real life. But it's just a little, it caught me off guard. I was expecting the Georgia Dome for a home game. And now we have this outdoor stadium. So, yeah, I didn't choose that because I'm doing purely as a coach. So the owner has chosen a new stadium for us, and I didn't take that option off. So I guess this is our new stadium, y'all. We got this. Wow, I like that screen, though.
Matt Bosher, ready to kick it away.
Oh, okay. All right, well, that works too, then. Let's do this. Long overdue.
A new season is upon us. Thomas is taking a knee here, so the ball will be spotted at the 20.
Owner didn't do anything. Oh, okay.
Charge of the Broncos offense today.
Matt Moore. Are you kidding me? We better tear him apart. I expect to be in his face. As a matter of fact, we're going to start off with a blitz. I expect this to be all in his face.
Lined up directly behind the quarterback here. The first week of the NFL season is underway.
Look at that.
And this will end up as a 2-yard loss.
That's how we start off a season.
This running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
You know, I think Beasley playing on that left side may actually be better. But this isn't a good test, though. We're going to send that same blitz again. We're going to make them beat us.
Second and 12. Anderson's got on the handle.
He got held up. He had some room, but he didn't do anything with it.
Trying to establish the run, but there's nothing there here at the start.
Yeah, it is. That D-line is doing his thing.
That's a bad job by the running back. He picked the wrong side to run to. Nobody was blocking.
Nick Fairley and Brandon Mabane are doing their thing out there. That's what I like to see. Third and 10.
Third down and 10.
And what did I say? I told you, the one weakness I felt was the secondary. We didn't blitz on that one, and that we definitely felt it there.
Can you believe how vertical he got there?
I can believe it, Jim Nance. I can, because we see it
yeah.
so often.
But he held his ground just then against Claiborne, even though he is a 60-something.
We take these catches for granted, but that was a tremendous play.
Oh, by the way, Mars in charge. I don't know if I had mentioned this to you or not. Rawlington already knows, but I post all my videos up on YouTube as well. Same name, Shakira725. So you can, you know, also subscribe there if you wanted to see how last season went. I have almost all of last season up. I still have some more editing to do before I get the rest of them up there. And then also you can also follow me on Twitter at Shakira725 as well. And I let you know on there too before I post. So that way you'll be able to, you know, see all these updates. And I appreciate, I saw that you subscribed or are following me on Twitch. So I do appreciate that as well.
Nice job that time by the tight end, makes the catch. And you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback.
Yeah, Fairley is dominating right now.
Balls lined up as the single back. First down at the 47.
Ooh, come on. Beasley got through but couldn't get there. Oh, really? Okay, cool.
Here's the starting.
Well, I just wanted to make sure I let you know, man. I appreciate it for both then.
Dangerous in a game like this. And it'll be second
Let's
down
go.
And 6 after
Let's
the running
go.
First down.
You know what? We're going to try with Fairley here. See what we can make him do. See, this passing has got to stop. It's not a bad idea.
Just move the chains. That's what they did with that throw and catch that time, Jim. It also gives them a chance for 3 more downs.
Looks like they're in press coverage here. First and 10. They'll go ground.
There we go.
The Falcons guessed right on the defensive side that time. They thought it was going to be a run play. They were all over it, and they got it in the backfield and made the tackle.
Loss of a couple.
See, that's what our defense needed last year when we were playing against doggone, what's he call it, Marshawn Lynch and Adrian Peterson. We needed that. I wish we had it last year.
Anderson's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. Second down and 12.
Oh, no.
Right back to him.
Anderson. Can't believe they sealed us right there.
After a gain of 10, he's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
All right, we need something coming off the outside edge.
Now third and short following the run.
We're killing this outside rush.
Moore's gonna take the snap from the shotgun. The Broncos get
it. We hit him, but he still got that pass off.
You know, when you throw the football like that down the field, you pick up a first down, now you can do anything you want.
Man, our guys are getting tired already. Come on now.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Moore's going to take it from the gun. Larry Donnell has the catch.
Here's what I'm going to do. I got an answer.
Hard to guard these tight ends.
I'm going to do what you said, Warrington, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually make the subset here. So instead of having Warlow in here, we're going to go ahead and put Weatherspoon in here for the dime sets. And now I can just run and dime, and he'll be there.
Continues.
Oh, now they don't want to run a play. We want to wait till the two. Wow. That was a fast first quarter. That was a very fast first quarter.
They bring in the extra tight end. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Unbelievable. Stop there. Matt Moore is 6 for 6. I would not have expected this.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
Moore 6 for 6 now with that completion.
False start.
5 yards with the false start penalty.
False start offense.
What a drive this has been. First and goal. The give. Picks up about 5.
And they are killing that.
The Broncos have really been dominant today.
We've been doing all right against the run. It's just except for that one big run.
Right at the defense and pick up solid yards.
Oh, gosh. Come on now.
Second and goal from the 6. Right.
What?
And a first touchdown.
Yeah, no kidding. Matt Manning for real out here. He's a 73 overall, and he's throwing like he's a 95.
The opening drive and go right down the field and score the touchdown. So many good plays in that drive right there.
Those 5 sacks might have to wait.
Hey, everybody in the offense is going to have confidence after that drive.
The Broncos were very effective on that scoring drive, especially via the pass. Over 50 passing yards on that scoring drive. And a touchback.
Ah, I did not mean to press it so soon. Wanted to see what they had to say about Matt Ryan. Oh, well.
To the line. Been a closely contested game so far.
Here we go. Chris Ivory wearing Michael Turner's number.
First down at the 20.
What the heck happened? 75. What was that?
Ivory's never
is that Awesome Moa?
That power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Ivory.
Oh, that don't seem right.
Backfield.
Jermaine Gresham is wearing Roddy White's number and he's playing on the line.
Down and 7. Finds Gresham.
That don't seem right.
And he's tackled down after picking up the first.
More cover 3 and press 2 man under. I'll give this a shot.
Sometimes they tell the receiver just to go long, run a fly route, run a 9 route.
We are going to
straight ahead or a streak.
change this one up.
You have and get it done.
I know I put Coleman in. He better be in. Yep.
First down and 10. Coleman's got it on the toss.
Now they take Coleman doing his thing out there. Had a lot of room to run.
If you're running back in this league and you pick up first downs and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
Matt Ryan under center. Coleman's taking it on the screen.
Man, where is the blocking? I mean, we had room. It was a nice setup, but we could have done more with that. I guess I outran him.
Right on the money, on a line, right into the receiver's hands. The football sits at the 40.
Yeah, it was. That run block was definitely beautiful. Here we go. Second and two.
And Ivory's hand at the football. Tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
There we go.
Ivory's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now you're
You know what? We're going to go ahead and try to toss play again. See if we can get outside again on him.
First down at the 36. Go running off the toss.
And face mask. Call a face mask. There it is. That's what we needed.
Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times
we're going to try to hit one to the newbie out there on the left side, Brandon.
Running so fast, they're trying to.
Oh, we'll try it on this next play.
Athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally.
Well, he's big enough. He's definitely big enough.
So now as we go back to the field, we've got a good game going, and an offense is trying to close the gap before halftime.
Watch Brandon get open
first
on this
ten.
One. Oh! You know what? He faked the crap out of the corner. The only reason the corner was in position to make a play there is because of the fact that he had gotten faked out. How jacked up is that? Because if you watch that play, Aqib Talib got shook.
And with that pick, it looks like the first half will end just the way it started with this defense.
Look at this. Oh, they didn't show it there.
This defense has
yeah, Aqib Talib got shook because he was stuck standing still.
They play fast, they play hard, and they just dare you to throw the football. Well, the offense.
I hate that we already then started off the season with another interception. All right. Let's do some two-man under press.
Now ready to take over again on offense. They were successful on their previous drive, getting the ball all the way to the end zone. I'm sure they're looking for more of the same right now.
Oh, absolutely. That's what you always want. You want to find your way to the end zone, and so many people contributed on that last.
Look at this mess, man. Look at this mess.
For putting the players.
We'll go cover three. See if that helps.
Awesome today on first down. That time it's a nice play.
Yeah, I did. I did force that pass.
Picks up solid yards. Second and short.
Well, I couldn't resist trying to throw to a new target, though.
The Broncos now move the chains.
How is he sensing this pressure? His awareness is low.
Jim, the defense gives up the first down that time inside the red zone, but there's only so many right. things the offense can do. Let's see if they can hold him.
Coming up to the line of scrimmage at the 11.
I don't know how he's sensing this.
They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. Complete to Cody Latimer. That's his first reception today.
Wow.
Do the little things right. When you do those right, you get big victories. And doing it right is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds, stop the clock, give his offense more chances.
What's up, Beasley? Doing all right, man.
Moore's back in shotgun formation.
Get there. Pick it! There it is! Let's go! Let's go! Heck yeah!
We're headed to the half, and could this be the spark this offense?
About doggone time. Matt Moore was perfect until then.
I hope so. You know, what you got to say to the offense is not the teaching moment here is this. just wake up and show some energy.
That is what we needed. We need to do on the offensive side. I don't even know if that's Godfrey. I don't think we have Godfrey on the team anymore. I'm not sure who that is. I don't know the names yet.
It's been a day for him so far, Phil.
It has. And, you know, if you want to get this team going, you want to find a way to get some momentum on your side, find a way to get the football to your star wide receiver. He's the guy.
That was Jenkins. That works.
He can just pick this whole team up and give them a much better chance to win.
Ryan from the gun, airing it out.
Yep. You don't even have to say it, man. I forced that one too. I did.
Mission is right around the corner, and they
appreciate it, Beasley. I appreciate you following me.
Hey, they want to go in at halftime, Jim.
Man, I can't believe I forced it twice in a row. But one on one for Julio. I mean, that's a legitimate. That's a legitimate throw.
In the first half.
You know.
Broncos will try to hold on to the football. This
I don't know.
One big turnover.
I don't know. We'll see.
Bill. Just what the coaches talked about in our meetings with him this week about ball security. It's not happening here.
Golly.
Players did not listen to the coach.
You don't have to say it wrong, dude.
Security is not what we're seeing out there. I know.
There's
going to be a lot of drills about hanging on to the football.
They come to the line of scrimmage.
If I get it back, I may just run it out and go into the half.
At the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. Anderson's got it on the screen.
Get him! There we go. Whirlow right there. That's what I needed to see. Speaking of which, I need to make another formation sub too for this one here. Because we got, whatchamacallit, Whirlow here. I want Weatherspoon in for this one too, since this is like one of my passing sets.
Line of scrimmage, the 43-yard line. Moore's got no one behind him, just a quarterback waiting for the snap. From the gun, Sanders.
Wow.
The first. That's his.
You said cover four. I can give it a try. But this is ridiculous. Matt Moore throwing 12 of 13. I don't know if I'm sending enough pressure on him. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to blitz the crap out of him right now.
Completion percentage, 90% on the day. He'll take the snap from the gun.
Yeah, you better throw that away. I think that might be the answer. Just send the house at him. We're going
to
do it again. Oh, they still got Demaryius Thomas out there, too. I forgot about that.
The Broncos from the 32.
No! Oh, come on. That line, or that running back picked up the sack block. Oh, goodness. We had him. We freaking had him.
It's a lot to talk about in the locker room.
Yeah, they are putting some kind of whipping on him here early in the game. I'll just say this for the defensive side that's losing.
Yep.
It's been terrible. So go in there at halftime.
But, you know, there wasn't a lot of deep room, but it was just enough.
Sanders taking a breather as the kicking team comes out. He just contributed over 60 yards receiving on that scoring drive.
That'll make up for it, though.
No one's gonna get him now. The 20.
Let's go, rookie. Touchdown. 105-yard touchdown return by Timmons. Let's go.
One, it takes talent by the kick returner, but look at all the good blocks we saw down the field and the speed of the kick returner.
That was a heck of a return right there by the rookie. Rookie making a huge, huge play. Let's go.
For the extra point.
Just kick this up and in.
Extra point is good.
We're going to squib this, bump that. We're not going to let him get a return here. We're going to squib. They don't have squib? Are you for real? All right, fine then.
Setting up here for the kickoff. Talib's got it. And the
We'll take it.
Right around the 25-yard line. We've reached the intermission. And soon we'll be sending you to Larry Ridley, who's going to break down all
this has not gone the way I expected.
As we send it to Orlando,
still a good game, but I definitely didn't expect for Matt Moore to look like Peyton Manning out here.
Sports halftime report. Both teams have done enough to be leading here to this point.
Look at our yards. You know, the second half, we got 50 total yards,
which should lead to some excitement.
Oh, this is awful.
Roll those highlights.
All right. We're ready. Another kickoff return here. Let's go.
This run caps off the drive with a score. They strike first in the half.
And he'll start his return.
Nope. Thought that one of them was going to pick up that end guy, but they didn't.
The Broncos defense trying to crack down yet again on the opposition.
Yeah, I know. I need to stop forcing them.
Leading the way for this team.
I like the way they played in the first half on the defense.
Look at his crap. Who was that? Oh, that was Toy Lolo on that side. I need to run toward Jermaine Gresham. That's what it is.
Go out there and attack this offense.
All right.
Falcons offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play. But what happens? The run loses.
Caps lock on, huh? Okay.
The offensive line.
Loss of three on the play.
Oh, that was there. As he was looking, that was there.
Now, careful. You can throw that out the window. Now it's time to be aggressive, take a chance, and put the defense on edge. Can you do that and give your team a chance to still win this game?
That was there.
Falcons will line up. The first down markers right at the 31-yard line.
There you go. And that was by the rookie, and that was not forced.
The Falcons just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Searching for space to the right.
That is why we picked up Chris Ivory right there. Saw the way he ran over that dude. Made it look easy.
Well, you can't knock them all down, and sometimes the running back has just got to break a tackle. Good job that time.
Second down and two to
go. Let's go.
After the running play. Coleman's got it on the toss. Running room.
It wasn't forced. Yep, it was. Finally, I got you. It wasn't forced. Let's go. First and 10.
The blocking and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
Coleman's got it.
Go. There we go, Coleman. Hold on to that ball. Please hold on to that ball.
Things haven't changed from when I played till now. When it's zone coverage, quarterbacks, offensive coordinator, and receivers.
Where is my play? There it is.
The line of scrimmage right at the 24.
Oh, I plan on it, especially with Ivory.
And Ivory's gonna secure.
Well, that didn't go anywhere.
He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
They read that very well, though.
On the way, third down. Two tight ends on the field here. Freeman's got it on the handle.
There we go, Freeman.
Beyond the markers. It's a first down.
The Falcons look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very.
Oh, shoot. What did I just call?
That first down. They're right in this game. Don't look down.
We're going to change this up because I don't know what I called.
Now first and 10. They feed it to him one more time.
I was not trying to hit juke right there.
Ivory's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up.
Here we go.
A short game.
Chris Ivory lined up in the backfield. Second down and 9.
Touchdown, Jermaine Gresham. Let's go.
That is the 25th touchdown catch of his career.
That was called patience right there. I waited on that to open up. Saw he had that room to the outside and then put it in there.
Play, and this game is all tied up. It's going to be a tense finish to this one, partner.
Yeah, I think it will be. But, you know, I felt the tension from the coaches trying to tie.
Boy, that kicker is tiny.
Some of the play calls were awful Finally, they relaxed, made some good play calls, and they got this game tied up.
The Broncos back deep, ready to receive.
Yeah, that's out the back. Let's go.
That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20.
Southward.
The Broncos have tried to stretch the field vertically, and they certainly have. Moore's been dropping back and airing it out.
He's had the time to air that football out. And what
see, our corners hadn't been able to keep up with them. Corners and safeties.
What does it do? It can get down the field behind the defense, and they are making.
Yeah, that rookie kicker is tiny. All right, let's go.
Picks up eight.
This is unbelievable.
The Broncos coaching staff has done a good job of mixing things up today on first down. The pass catches the defense off guard. They pick up solid yards. Now it's second and short.
Second down and two.
There it is. Beasley meeting him in the backfield. Let's go. Let's go.
My gosh, he is one happy guy. Anytime you get in the backfield and stop the runner and make him lose yards, that's some good stuff.
Loss of five on the play. From the gun. C.J. Anderson with the catch.
Oh, my gosh. I hope we stopped him. Fourth and inches, okay.
They're well taught, well schooled by the defensive coordinator. They know in situations like this, if it's thrown short of the first down marker, they're good. They come up, make the tackle. Now we have fourth down.
That was way too close.
Start the fourth quarter. We're all tied up, Phil. And can both of these defenses continue to match one another here?
Yeah, it's been fun to watch this. It's been a fantastic defensive game here today. And I think it comes down to this. Which defense is going to be stronger, can create that turnover, and give his team a great chance to win.
Touchback now as the ball comes.
Here we go. Got the chance here to go up now. We need to drive down the field and do our thing.
They couldn't stop the run the last time they were on the field.
Oh, my gosh. And the coaches are furious with the way they played. I thought the defensive calls were good. The techniques and the execution was awful.
The Falcons now march to the line. Tightly contested game here in the fourth. The score's 14-14. First down at the 20.
What the heck?
All over that offense and bring.
How did he
down.
Slide through?
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down.
All right.
Now the defense is in a good situation.
Second down and 11. Gresham's got it. First down.
There we go.
That's his third catch of the day.
He said, run the clock. I'm always hesitant about doing that when it's tied up, and I'm going to tell you why. Because if I mess up and I throw an interception or I don't get it, you know, something happens and I don't score and they get the ball back, then I didn't hurt myself. You get what I'm saying? So I usually like to at least wait until I have a one-touchdown lead on them before I try to start running the clock. Or one-score lead, rather.
Miller's the one who made the big stop.
But that's just my own personal thing right there.
Defense is so fast and so powerful. That time of the run play, they just overpower the offensive line, and they tackle the runner for a loss.
Ivory, the lone setback this time. Second and 12. Jones got
there we go.
Some heat on
Julio. Julio still the easy go-to target.
Can you believe how steady and reliable this guy is?
He is. Is it, what's the phrase for it? He is money, Jim Nantz. Man, he pays off every single time. You throw the football near him, he'll make the catch.
Ryan's completion percentage, 70% on the day. And that's Jackson.
Tripped over someone, but he still got yards, so I'll take it.
That's what you call a bullet pass. Very little space to throw the football into, but he gets it done. A lot of velocity.
If I had known he was going to catch that block on the outside, I probably would have tried to take it outside.
Set up now at the 36.
Use Freeman and Coleman more during the drive and Ivory when you need the short yardage. True, I could.
And Ivory's handed the football. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains.
Ivory's. I mean, I like the power that he brings, though. I definitely like that power.
He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them.
Tell you what, we'll do it like this. We'll put Freeman in here for this formation, since I do like this one. Oh, we're going to flip that. Jermaine Gresham's a better run blocker anyway. Holding. Doggone holding.
Holding offense.
Yep.
The defense accepts the penalty.
This time we will run that quick toss outside.
First down at the 36. Outside now on the toss.
That works. Tevin Coleman doing his thing in this game. 71 rushing yards. That's not bad at all.
Good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
It depends on the game. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. Speaking of Hardy, by the way.
That's his first reception today.
I think that was Hardy. Yep.
Coordinator does a good job that time calling the pass down here in the red zone. Caught the defense off guard. They got the completion for a good game. Ryan's now completed his last seven passes. Freeman's got it on the handle.
There we go.
2 minutes to go.
2 minute warning. See if this ISO run will work.
Back now when this one time is running out here in the fourth quarter.
See, Hardy got on the field, doggone it.
Takes it again.
In there.
For six. Touchdown.
Let's go. Chris Ivory getting the touchdown.
By scoring on the ground.
Now, y'all know normally I would run that with the fullback. I did that with Ivory just because we can now.
They caught the defense by surprise. And then the other team, hey, the other team, they've been working on their two-minute offense also. This is going to be an exciting finish.
That is a tiny kicker. I can't get over how small he is. He's like 5'6 or something.
The Falcons ready here for the kickoff.
Uh-oh, that's the short kick.
Thomas is going to start his return. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. Well, partner, it looks like it all comes down to this. And when this team finds itself in these...
Yep, 21 unanswered points. Let's hope we can keep it that way.
Right there is almost always the one they turn to.
Yeah, you did mention that about Ivory last year, too. I do remember that.
That's why he's one of the star running backs in the NFL. So you don't go away from him.
I definitely remember
like
that.
Give him that football and let him do his thing. And you can feel the tension in the air. First down. Pressure on every snap now.
False start. Let's go. Push him back some more. Push him back some more.
False start. Offense.
You don't even have to ask.
Now yep. On first down. Every snap crucial the rest of the way. From the gun. Thomas.
Way to get in the way.
And the pass is incomplete.
Yeah, I mean, it was a surprise. We got pretty much everyone we wanted, you know, so we definitely had a good offseason. My only concern is if we'll be able to maintain it, because it was a lot of players that we picked up. And, you know, salary cap issues going forward could be an interesting ordeal.
Second and long. Larry Donnell has the catch.
Come on, Southward. You are one-on-one with a tight end. You should be able to stop that.
first at this point. Moore standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Anderson's got it, and a first. First down, pressure on every snap now.
Good job by the offense going the hurry-up offense. You do this to get the plays in, but also you want to conserve the timeouts.
Man, we cannot get to Matt Moore. This is frustrating.
50 after this play. Every play.
Yeah, I heard that we were looking at Monty Ball.
This is a time when communication is paramount. You're in the hurry-up. No,
there we go.
And you must score.
Yeah, that's right.
Come on.
They know the rules. They know what they're supposed to do. They practice it many, many times. No reason to make a mental mistake in this situation.
Trailing every third down so big at this point. Moore's got it in the gun. Donnell with the reception. Jenkins is
what
there
the heck?
Time for the tackle. Now on first down. Every snap crucial the rest of the way. Going to go to the hurry up with under a minute to play.
Pickett! Come on! That would have been game. Oh, come on. Oh my gosh. Switch Durant and Reed. I have to look at that. I will. I'll take a look at that.
Ball lines up in the backfield. First and 10.
Get there. Golly. What? Oh, I was about to say. Don't let Demaryius Thomas come up with that one.
On the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
Moore's got everybody split out wide. Second and 10.
No.
And good catch.
Oh, come on. You ought to not let him come down with that.
Arm strength is a nice thing to have when the window of opportunity is very small. Quarterbacks with strong arms can still fire it in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
Moore's completion percentage, 80% on the day. They'll go shotgun here. Looking across the middle. Two hands on the football.
This is incredible. This is absolutely incredible.
On every snap now.
If you think you can get a playoff quickly and not use a timeout, you go with a hurry-up offense. That time, a good job by the coach and the quarterback.
Ball is out.
There it is.
The Broncos decide to take
there we go.
Here, leaving them with only one. The Broncos head to the line. They've got one timeout left here in the fourth quarter. Huge play coming up down near the goal line. Second and long. Stands in the pocket.
Good defense.
As this goes incomplete.
Yeah, Beasley is coming so close to a sack.
For these teams, and it's been about two teams getting it done in different ways.
What we're seeing is two different philosophies on the offensive side from these teams here today, Jim. And it doesn't matter. All you want to do is just get it done.
Huge play coming up. Offense looking for one more play to make. Third and forever. And the reception.
There we go. Good tackle. Good tackle, Spoon. Oh, man.
They bring back out the offense to go for it. Back at the line. They're going for it on fourth.
This is it.
Moore's gonna take the snap from the shotgun. Scans the field.
Out of bounds! Let's go! Let's go!
Inability to produce the conversion on fourth down in all likelihood signals the end of their last chance to win this game.
In situations like this, I know the coaches and his teammates all expect him to come through. But not that time. Just not a good throw.
The Falcons offense is on the field for a victory bow. One kneel down, and then they can celebrate, Phil. What a feeling.
Yeah, it's got to be great for them, and what a difference.
That is how we do it week one. Doggone it.
And look at the defense. Everybody head down.
That's how we do it week one.
Was for nothing.
Started off down 14-0.
Nothing like winning that opening game of the season.
Really?
Bill.
Okay.
It really is, Jim.
I didn't see how he did. I was focused on the defense as a whole. But if you only allow one catch, that's a great game right there.
And then you go out there and you win, man, you get to sit back.
Especially since he was probably covering Demaryius Thomas the whole game. What a way to win that. Oh, my goodness. Play of the game goes to that kick return touchdown, though, in my opinion. Because that was a nice kick return touchdown. Jermaine Gresham had a decent game, too. What was that throw? It was Matt Moore finally acting like Matt Moore. That's what that throw was. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You're talking about when I pressed everyone and sent the blitz? Yeah, that's true. He did allow that one. But, yeah, we did a good job otherwise. I'm actually pretty happy with the way that game came out. Wish we would have had more sacks on the play. I mean, on the game. I think we had just one, maybe two. But all in all, it worked out well. Yeah, that worked out very well. And I'll advance this week. That's what I like to see. You know the next week is going to be tough, though, since we got the Seahawks again. Hate the Seahawks. Not hate them, but I'd hate playing against them, rather. It's just not fair. That's how I feel. All right, let's advance to the next week. I will. I'll look into that, actually, before I log off real quick. Switching Reed and Durant around. Oh, man, oh, man. I'm so pumped about that win. Yeah, he did. He did. I'm tempted to put, because Claiborne, if you didn't notice, Claiborne and Beasley kind of flip-flopped. Normally, it's the other way around. And so I think if Beasley had been on that side, he probably would have had more success and vice versa. So I'm thinking I'll probably flip these two back around, Claiborne and Beasley, you know? So in order to do that, we'll move Beasley down real quick and then come back here and put Beasley up here and then come back over here and put Claiborne. And then Claiborne up here in place of Cliff Matthews. And then we wanted to look at the outside linebackers. Yeah, it feel like it, man. It definitely feel like it. So, Reed and Durant. What is Reed's speed, out of curiosity? 81, and Durant is 83, so a little bit better, yeah. 87 acceleration versus 90 acceleration. So, Reed is probably more of a downhill runner when it comes to it. But you know what? I'll go ahead and make that switch. Wait a minute. Dang it, I didn't mean to back out. I had him selected. I couldn't get him off. All right, depth chart. They killed me in the playoffs? I wouldn't say killed. It was a 14-point game in the end. I mean, granted, it was, you know, more like 21. We just kind of got that last-minute score. But still, 14-point game in the end. I'm going to take it like that. Durant. And then we're going to put Reed. Then move Reed up. And move Durant back up. You know, we didn't even look to see about Vincent Ray, the new guy. You know, I don't know if he got in at all. But that 83 speed there as well. You know. 96 tackle. Yeah, he does. I'm tempted to put Vincent Ray over Justin Durant, actually. I've been looking at that, too. I mean, 96 tackling, but his hit power isn't there, so he's not going to force any fumbles. That's one downside with him. But he's got better block shed. Doesn't have as good play recognition. They're about the same on speed. Justin Duran will start for now, I guess. Yeah, he's better power move, better finesse. We can get off blocks and whatnot, rush. Their pass, man zone, same. Yeah, Duran will stay there for now. Yeah. There we go. So we got Durant and Reed flip spots. And Vincent Rey is still here. All in all, that was a good game, though. I like the way my team performed. You know. Who was that safety? Who was it? That was a... Who was it, number 40? Was that a corner? Oh, that was... No, Janoris Jenkins, 30. Who was 40? Oh, that was Timmons. That's right. Never mind. But yeah, Jenkins was the one that made that interception on that play. That was huge. Anyway, that was fun. Next time on here, we got to play against the Seattle Seahawks once again. You can see we're at 1-0. Saints at 1-0 starting out. I'm sure the Seahawks are at 1-0 if I were to check. I would be shocked if they weren't. Yep, 1-0. They won their game 49-31. Yeah. I could always sub in different things, yeah. But anyway, I appreciate y'all watching. Like I said, it'll probably be a couple of days before I get these out because I got to do a lot of editing with the videos and stuff like that. But I have week 17. I got divisional round of playoffs. I got the off season to post up. And then this video. But they will eventually make their way up there. I'm still in the process of editing week 17 right now. But I'd like to thank y'all for watching. Can I check what? Can I check my re-signs? Oh, you want to see who I can re-sign this year? Let me take a look real quick then. True. Oh, no, not True Font this year. All right, he's a priority, obviously. Robert Alford's on that list. Tahoe Lolo's on that list. We got some big names up here for us. Kamal Ishmael's on that list. Yeah, we got some names up here that we got to take care of. Renfrey. So we'll make sure to do that. I almost want to offer True Font right now, actually. Whoa. Man, that's a high salary amount, but, you know, he wants it. And for what he delivers to this team, we can't be cheap right now. 5 years, 54 mil. He asking for 53 and a half. We're going to give him 54 mil. Come on. Yes! Trufon is signed. We don't have to worry about him. All right. I'll worry about the rest later on. I may sign Kamal Ishmael before the start of the next game, too. But for now, though, we are good. Again, I'd like to thank you all for watching, though. Continue to check it out. Like, subscribe, follow, all that good stuff. And I will talk to you all later. Follow me on Twitter if you aren't already doing it, and I'll let you know when I'm on next. At Shakir725. Y'all have a good one, though.